गुड मॉर्निंग, नमस्कार, आदाब, सत श्री अकाल। फ्रेंड्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लाइजेन कंडेंसेशन। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल लर्न ए सुपर ट्रिक। ओके फ्रेंड्स,
अभी मजा आएगा ना।
सो लेट अस स्टार्ट। क्लाइजेन कंडेंसेशन is very very important for all competitive examinations like IIT, IIT JAM, NEET, NET, GET and etc. So friends, Claisen condensation is similar to Aldahl condensation. In Aldahl condensation we take carbonyl compounds, aldehyde or ketone, having at least one alpha hydrogen. And in Claisen condensation, we take ester, having alpha hydrogen. In product, in Aldahl condensation, we get beta hydroxy aldehyde or beta hydroxy ketone, and in Claisen condensation we get beta keto ester. So these two are very much similar. As far as Claisen condensation is concerned, when ethyl acetate, when ester, when ester having alpha hydrogen is heated with sodium methoxide, beta keto ester is formed. Friends, in Claisen condensation, carbon-carbon bond, new carbon-carbon bond is formed, first thing. And second thing is, that is alpha-beta trick. Alpha-beta bond is formed, means a new bond, I am telling carbon-carbon bond. The new bond formed is in between alpha-carbon and beta-carbon. So these two things you have to remember. Okay, here let us see it is ester. Take two molecules of ethyl acetate, CH3 COOCH5, ethyl acetate. It is ethyl acetate. This molecule gets converted into carbonyl. Here you are using sodium ethoxide. Sodium ethoxide means this base, ethoxide ion is a strong base. It will extract this hydrogen, leading to formation of carbonyl, that is nucleophile. That nucleophile will attack here. So you will get CH3 C double bond O. Again it will revert, it will come back with elimination of ethoxide ion, because ethoxide ion is used, and ethoxide ion further will be released. So it is used as catalyst, we say. So CH3, C double bond O, and this unit gets attached here, CH2, C double O, C2H5. This product you will get. It is ester group, So it is alpha carbon and it is beta carbon and it is beta keto ester. Beta keto ester. Okay. Obviously, I have written beta keto ester is four. But it is an important compound that is ethyl estoestate. Ethyl, actually, if H would be here, then it is acetoacetic acid. It is CH3COOH acetic acid, and this is aceto group, so it is acetoacetic acid, and it is ethyl acetoestate. Ethyl acetoacetate. Ethyl acetoacetate. Okay? Or aceto, it is aceto. It is acetoacetic ester. Acetoacetic ester. It is very, very important compound because this methylene group is active methylene group. Active methylene group. Why it is called active methylene group? This methylene group is sandwiched between this and this electron withdrawing group. These two electron withdrawing groups will withdraw the same paired electrons, leading to delta plus positive charge at this carbon. As positive charge is developed at this carbon, that carbon, positively charged carbon, will withdraw the said paired electron of carbon hydrogen bond. So hydrogen, these two hydrogens are liable to release from here easily. These two hydrogen atoms can be released as proton. So these two hydrogen atoms are acidic, and that's why we say that this group is active methylene group. Okay, all these are about statement and reaction of Claisen condensation. With the help of Claisen condensation, we get a very much important compound, that is ethyl acetate. Now we will see its mechanism. In first step, CH3COOC2H5, it is ethyl acetate. It is ethoxide ion coming from sodium ethoxide. This hydrogen is extracted and ethyl alcohol is released. And you are getting this carbon ion which will act as nucleophile. It is nucleophile. Of course, carbon ion is nucleophile. In second step, CH3, C double bond O, OC2H5, it is again ethyl acetate ester. This is first molecule, this is second molecule, and first molecule gets converted into nucleophile, and this nucleophile will attach at this carbonyl carbon, because this carbonyl carbon consists of positive charge. Delta plus charge is here, so this nucleophile can attack at this carbonyl carbon. And you know that nucleophile attacks on carbonyl carbon dhakadhak. Nucleophile attacks on carbonyl carbon dhakadhak. The reason is clear. It is negatively charged and it is positively charged. Okay, so it is nucleophile which will attack in this fashion. Okay, and you get CH3 minus OC2H5 CH2 COOC2H5. Okay, when it comes by this ethoxide ion is released OC2 as 5 minus ethoxide ion is released and you get CH3 C double bond O CH2 C double O C2 H5. It is alpha, it is beta, beta keto ester, beta keto ester or ethyl ester state or aceto acetate ester. Now we will compare it with aldol condensation. So write comparison between Claisen condensation and aldol condensation. So make a table Claisen condensation and aldol condensation. In Claisen condensation, reactant is ester. Reactant is ester. Reactant is carbonyl compound. Reactant is carbonyl compound. Alpha hydrogen must be present. Alpha hydrogen must be present. Alpha hydrogen must be present. Product is beta keto ester product is beta hydroxy carbonyl compound beta hydroxy carbonyl compound. Formation of new carbon-carbon bond. Formation of new carbon-carbon bond. Number 5. Alpha-beta trick is here. Means alpha-beta bond is formed. Carbon-carbon bond, new carbon-carbon bond means the bond, covalent bond formed is between alpha carbon and beta carbon. So I say alpha-beta trick. In aldol condensation, there is alpha-beta trick. In Claisen condensation, there is alpha-beta trick. Alpha-beta trick is here. Alpha-beta trick is here. Number six. In Claisen condensation, we use base used is sodium ethoxide. Base used is sodium ethoxide. Number six. Base used is dilute NaOH. Sodium ethoxide is more basic than that dilute NaOH. So we use here sodium ethoxide. But at both places, base is used. Number 7. We will compare the mechanism. Friends, up to 0.6, all things are similar. In both sides, cases are similar. And here also, cases will be similar. The mechanism, it is collagen condensation. You will get ethyl acetate. And this base, ethoxide ion will extract this hydrogen leading to anion. It is carbon ion. And here you use carbonyl compound having alpha hydrogen. Here it is ester having alpha hydrogen. It is the group and it is alpha carbon. So alpha hydrogen is there. CH2CHO. Suppose it is esterdehyde. It is sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide which will extract this hydrogen leading to carbon ion, that is nucleophile. It is nucleophile in first step. In second step, it is ethyl acetate. It is second molecule of esterdehyde. This anion, this nucleophile will attack here. CH3CO minus OC2H5 CH2COOC2H5. Okay? And here this nucleophile will attack here. You will get CH3CO minus H CH2CHO. This very much similar mechanism is very close to each other. And now when it will come back, it will be released. So ethoxide ion is released leading to this ethyl acetate, that is beta keto ester. When it comes back, this ethoxide ion is released leading to this. And here, when this hydroxide ion takes this hydrogen as H plus, water is released. And here that water will give H plus leading to CH3, this. In third step, ethoxide ion is released. Here this supplies H plus leading to beta hydroxy LEI. So all points up to we have discussed 7 points in comparison between collagen condensation and aldol condensation, and all these 7 points are very close to each other. So friends, we discussed a lot about collagen condensation. Hope you will like this. Thank you.